was such a big blessing, the call to worship, that we could well go home right now. But don't get your hopes up. Before I get to the welcome, Jared Knapp, our deacon's chairman, asked me to announce that during the welcome, deacons or fellows will be handing out deacon election ballots. I believe that's right. And so you take those and fill those out and then put them in the offering plate. Did I get it right, Jared? Okay. And again, before I get to the welcome, Jared also asked me to sneak in a commercial about my book signing event scheduled for Logan Street on Sunday morning, October 16. And that will begin at 11:30 at the close of the morning worship. I say about 11:30, depending on how long the guest preacher speaks that morning. His initials are WG. And so you never know about how long-winded he'll be. But we'll begin as soon as the service is over, and then I'll continue to be here until about 3 that afternoon. That's October 16 for a book signing for my new book on Philippians, which is supposed to be delivered to our house this week. Now to the welcome. And it is my privilege to welcome you. Mary and I are really glad to be back home here today and to welcome you to Logan Street. I'm a bit nervous because once as your interim pastor, I got up here and welcomed everybody to Winstanley. It's hard to break old habits. And so I'm making sure that it's Logan Street that I welcome you to today for worship. We're glad you're here. If you are a guest, please fill out a guest card and place that in the offering plate, and we'll appreciate it. Now to the welcome. One day at chapel in at the old Baptist Foundation at SIU Carbondale, the speaker told about a man who one Sunday morning was backing out of his driveway with his wife on their way to church. And his neighbor was mowing his yard. And the man said to his wife, "There ought to be a law against mowing your yard on Sunday." Sometime later, he was backing out of his driveway on their way to a ball game, and his neighbor was mowing his yard. And the man said to his wife, "Oh, I'm glad I don't have to be out there mowing my yard today." And then he got to thinking, "Why didn't I say that when I was on my way to church? Oh, I'm glad I don't have to be out there mowing my yard today." So, what was your attitude and spirit on your way to church today? Were you so glad you get to go to church today to worship God? This might be a good time in the sacred privacy of your soul to thank God for the privilege of worship, and it really is a privilege.
Teach me your ways, O Lord, that I may live according to your truth. Grant me purity of heart, that I might honor you with all my heart. I praise you, Lord. I give glory to your name forever, for your love for me is great. As we give God all the glory this morning, let's stand to our feet and sing, "To God be the glory."
To God be the glory, great things done. So loved he the world that he gave us his Son. In his life and atonement for sin, and open the life gate that all may go in. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Let the earth hear his voice. Praise the
This morning, I told the choir to enjoy the moment of worshiping Him, not thinking about our past, not thinking about what's happening as soon as the service is over, but enjoying worship, enjoying the Spirit move amongst us. Let's sing together. These are the days.
These are the days of Elijah, declaring the word. Servant Moses, righteousness be restored.
And though these
are days of great trials, of famine and darkness and sore, still we are the voice in the desert cry, prepare ye the way of the Lord. Behold, He comes, riding on the clouds, shining like the sun. Trumpet call.
Praise his name this morning. You may be seated.
Thank you. We are truly blessed at this church. If you would see this choir, has it not grown and gotten a lot better? Yes, it has. How about our congregation, too? Very good. I issue you a challenge. There was a story that was told that I read one day. This golf coach was talking to his team, and he said, look at that older gentleman out there walking on the golf course. If he can walk 18 holes every day, you don't need to ride in a cart, you can too. And Wendell and Mary drive here from Swansea on Sundays. I challenge you every Sunday to be here. Think about that challenge, that God wants you in his house each Sunday, each time those doors are open. Even on Wednesday nights, you need to be here for the various prayer meetings that we have. Okay? Let's go to the word in prayer. Our dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day. We are truly blessed, Lord, with the congregation we have, with the church that we have, and with the people that are making up that church. We have great teachers, Lord, and Lord, we always look to you for insight. Father, you are so good to us, and with this offering, may we in some small way return that to you. Bless us as a congregation. May we continue to grow, Lord. May we continue to work in this community for you. And Father, we will give you all the blessings that we can. And we just thank you for everything you do for us. We ask these things in your holy name. Amen.
Dance with anticipation. The trembling clouds, they know it's time. Musicians are tuning their instruments, and the singers are humming. Here comes the
God, I am.
triumphantly. The church will rise. What a great message. Psalm 29. Listen to this. Honor the Lord, you heavenly beings. Honor the Lord for his glory and his strength. Honor the Lord for the glory of his name. Worship the Lord in the splendor of his holiness. As we honor him this morning with our worship and our singing at his name, let's sing about that glorious name of Jesus. Sing with me.
As morning dawns and evening fades,
sing to him.
You inspire songs of praise that rise from earth to touch your heart and glorify your name.
Sing your name.
Your name is a strong and mighty tower. Your name is a shelter like no other. Your name, let the nations sing you loud. Nothing has the power to save but your name.
And we pray in his name this morning that true worship will be sung. Let's lift our voices. Jesus.
Jesus, in your name we pray.
Lord, give
us strength to live
and glorify your name.
And glorify your name.
Your name,
your name is a strong and mighty tower. Your name is a shelter like no other. Your name. Sing it loud, 'cause nothing has the power to save your name. Your name is a strong and mighty tower. Your name is a shelter like no other. Your name, let the nations sing it loud.
hallelujah to the one true Lord. As we stand to our feet in worship of our one true Lord, let's lift our song, let's lift our praises, let's lift our joy to Him and His salvation, His grace. Sing with me. Hallelujah. His holy name. sing hallelujah.
Hallelujah to the King of Kings. Hallelujah to the Lamb. Hallelujah to the Lord of Lords, who is the great I am.
Heavenly Father, we sing hallelujah to you this morning, knowing that you are the great I am, that you are our Lord, that you are our Savior, our Deliverer, our Healer, our Protector, our Salvation. As we have lifted our voices to you in a genuine worship to get to know you, to praise you, and to be those that glorify you, I pray, Lord, that you do the same with Brother Wendell as he gives his message, that we are encouraged, that we are blessed, and that we grow closer to you. Thank you, for Lord, for the works you are doing at Logan Street Baptist Church. How we not only worship you and engage you on Sundays, but we go into the community knowing that you are our God and our Savior. We love you so much, and hallelujah, we are saved. It's in your name we pray. Amen. You may be seated.